morning students, welcome to the class. In the previous classes we have discussed introduction of microcontrollers, differences between microprocessors and microcontrollers, and variants of MSP430 microcontroller and MSP430 microcontroller introduction, and architecture of MSP430 microcontroller register set. And today we are discussing about addressing modes of MSP430 microcontroller. So first of all, what is meant by addressing mode? Addressing mode is the way of specifying the data to be operated by an instruction, or it can also be defined as addressing mode is the manner in which the operand is given by an instruction or in an instruction, right? So there are 7 addressing modes in MSP430 microcontroller. They are named as: first one, register addressing mode; next, second one, indexed addressing mode; third one, symbolic addressing mode; fourth one, absolute addressing mode; fifth one, indirect register addressing mode; sixth one, indirect auto increment addressing mode; seventh one, immediate addressing mode. So let us see one by one in detail. So addressing mode is nothing but the way we are defining the operand in an instruction, how operands are going to be defined in an instruction. So there are instructions where we have single operands or multiple operands or no operands. So the way how to define the operands is defined by an addressing mode in an instruction. First one, let us start from the first one, register addressing mode. So before starting this, just try to recollect what we have studied in 8086 microprocessor, addressing modes of 8086 microprocessor. In 8086 microprocessor, we are writing the instruction like if we take data transfer instruction, MOV, this is the mnemonic, AX comma BX. So what is the function of this instruction? The content, whatever is available in AX, is transferred to BX. So here, whatever the content available in BX is transferred to AX, right? Here AX is destination register and BX is source register. So we are defining the operands: first destination operand, next source operand. The content available in the source operand is transferred to destination in case of 8086 microprocessor, whereas in case of MSP430 microcontroller, we will write the instruction like this. Example data transfer instruction I am taking: move dot b r4 comma r5. Here this b represents byte. So we have also explained that MSP430 microcontroller can also be used as 8-bit controller or 16-bit controller. So for that reason, in each and every instruction, we have to, there are bytes as well as words, right? If you write the instruction like this, the meaning of this is move dot b, b represents byte. Byte is transferred from this register to this register. Here in this instruction, this is source operand, this is destination operand. Here in case of 8086 microprocessor, destination is written first, source is written next. The content available in source is transferred to destination. But in case of MSP430 microcontroller, source is written first, destination is written next. The content available in source is transferred to destination. That is, whatever R4 contains, it is transferred to R5, right? And B represents byte. The meaning of this B is, so we can define byte or word in an instruction. If you want to transfer one byte of data from this register to this register, you have to represent the instruction move.b. If you want to transfer word, complete 16 bits of data from R4 to R5, you have to write the instruction move.word R4 comma R5. 16 bit, that is word, is transferred from R4 to R5. Here, byte, 8 bits, is transferred from R4 to R5. So by this way, we can start the explanation of addressing modes. Let us come to register addressing mode. So in register addressing mode, there are two operands. One is source operand and the second one is destination operand. The content available in source is transferred to destination. So we have a total how many registers? There are 16 registers, right? Among these 16 registers, 0 to R0 to R3 are special registers. Registers like PC status register and constant generator registers. And R4 to R15 are general purpose registers. Right? So, in order to transfer information from source register to destination register, we can make use of this register addressing mode. The syntax of this addressing mode is move dot byte R4 comma R5, right? This is source operand. This is destination operand. Let us see example. Example move dot b R4 comma R5. If R4 contains 1234H, R5 contains 1111H, this is before execution, after execution what will you get? R4 contains 1234H, R5 contains 1234H. The contents of source operand is transferred to destination operand, and source doesn't change. The content of source is transferred to destination, right? If it is here, we have given example of byte. Only a byte of information is transferred here, right? If it is a word, move dot word R4 comma R5. Example 2. So before execution, this is dual H, this is dual H. Before execution, R4 contains 1234H, R5 contains 1111, H. So after execution, what will we get is, after execution, R4 contains 1,2,3,4 H, and R5 contains 1,2,3,4 H. The content of source operand is transferred to destination, right? And the source operand cannot change. Only the content available in source register, that is R4, is transferred to R5. This is about register addressing mode. So there are two operands, source operand and destination operand. The content of source operand is transferred to destination operand. This is source operand, destination operand. This is for byte. Example, this is for word. Let us see about indexed addressing mode.